Hello everyone and welcome back. Let's play some more Bohemia. It always looks weird that I start with the technology tab open, but the thing is that when I press F5 to start recording, it just opens by itself, so I can never press F5 ever again because it just stops the recording. Anywho, let's play some more Bohemia. I have a lot of money, by the way. As you can probably see, 1,100 ducats is not a small amount by any estimate. Now, I can't tell which one are my lands, so I'm just going to do this. Kiev is my land, though the Stonehill Fort has been already building here. We're going to attack this guy next, Poland. And this is not my land because it's probably some kind of wrong holding type thing. And the problem is that once I die, my lands are just going to split up again. And I need good allies. So I'm hoping my son will inherit my lands. And not this guy. This guy could be just a pretty bad thing over here. No, actually, fine. Let's see, let's educate my son. 9 already. Wow, time flies. Educate child by a this woman is pretty good. A kinswoman. Educate myself, please. Anyway, my daughters, one is already married, the other one is not married, she's 24. She is marrying the High Chief of Brandenburg. High Chief of Wallachia. High Chief of Carvuna, maybe this guy. A little bit old for him, but it doesn't really give a little cares. Anywho. Yes, that's the way you cannot. I do want to reform the Slavic faith, because once we are reformed, we're in one of the best states that we could ever be. Every one of my lands, every one of these dukes and counts and kings is going to be pretty strong against the Catholics and the Muslims, and we could actually think of pushing down and taking stuff from Greece and things like that. Anywho, this guy doesn't hate me as much as he used to, which is surprising. I would build a hill fort in this guy's land and in this guy's land, just for the sake of building one. These guys have already quite a good land, because they have castles, rather than having just some normal, rather than just having some tribes. And Bohemian has pushed out down here, I mean, a little bit, so it could actually kind of assimilate everything. Bohemian West Slavic, so we could take this land. Juliana, my wife, is pregnant again. She could bear me a son, but that would even ruin even more of my succession. Anyway, the only thing we're waiting for is them to take plot. I was thinking we could take this part, this place. So just switch it around a little bit. And I can hear a sneeze coming. My kinswoman for him. Do we have an alliance with you? We probably won't. We don't, so whatever. But at least we have good relations. Allowed a marriage. And both just kind and state diplomacy. So that 10 modifier is good at least. These Norse guys should just start taking lands from these guys, but I don't know if the Viking Age has started. I forgot if the modifier just appeared. The event appeared, but whatever. There's only one province that is Orthodox. You could convert that at least. Do it, dudes. I'm looking for something to actually do. These places should start converting like wildfire, but I don't know why. And it's probably because they don't have that much moral authority. There is this holy site up here. Second, yep, this holy site, no. Novogorod, which if we took it, would actually, if we took both of these, actually just make it much more possible for us to reform our faith, but I don't know. That actually will become a temple. They would actually build a temple rather than building a... rather than me being the head of our religion, there will be a high priest in the temple stuff. So that's pretty interesting, but I don't know. This guy's revolting apparently. Yep. This guy's the leader. The king of Serbia has died. And his kingdoms have split up. Croatia is its own independent kingdom now, with a Serbian king. But still. But I've double aligned with these guys. Yup. My grandsons. Okay, that's interesting. Both of them. Both of them the same dynasty. But still different kingdoms. Okay, we're going to war right away. Claim on Rügen, and we might take Novogorod. So I'm sending one up there right away. Right here. And I'm raising my armies, calling my allies. Call to arms the king of Croatia and the king of Serbia. To children. They probably won't join because they're pretty weak in their childlike forms. One joined and the other joined, so both pretty lucky. They don't have that many troops though, because they're children. The younger you are, the less points you have, and the less you can actually do with war and stuff. Just go attacking them again. This shouldn't be a long war, and it shouldn't be a hard war. Is this Slavic down here? It is Slavic, it's Pomeranian, but Slavic. That's 99% done already. And one more battle should just facilitate our victory. Okay, surrender. Surrender under acceptance. Okay. How much moral authority do we have now? 40%. So we need one more holy site. What are you? What is the leader? Who is this guy? Revoke title, Temple of Ardan. Okay, he accepted my decision. So I'm finding a man who is not imprisoned, who is not a ruler, who is of my religion and my culture. He is an adult, not from a great house. And you are becoming the Templar, the priest or something. 24, that's not bad. Where's Novogorod? Here, take that too. So it's 45 right now. So we could probably just do it like this. But I do want to take Novogorod too. And I will just release Novogorod, or maybe just keep it as a symbol, but not really fight many wars. If I get tempted into a corner for that, I would just throw it away. You are married with this guy who is my vassal, Karaguna. Okay, more money. Thank you. I don't really care if I get greedy or deceitful. I already have greedy, and I am deceitful, so... What are you expecting from a greedy, deceitful guy? Let's build this. And let's keep constructing stuff everywhere. Because once we kind of turn into a once we turn into a real kingdom with castles and stuff, it will be very hard to fight all the modifiers that I will lose. And then there are these guys. This guy who has conquered everything left after I conquered Kiev is just growing crazy. Is he a Slav though? Yes he is, so should kind of befriend him or something. He's just east of everything I own. Second lot, I have three. Okay, so this one I took. So he just took everything that I'm losing. Only kind of problem is Crimea, we should just conquer any day now. Waiting for one more claim, dude. These guys are losing their revolt. They're uprising, they're losing it. Anyway, I don't really care about some Norse filthy pagans. Whatever. Herja Afmunso. This always changes, but Afmunso is always they're always the kings of Sweden. That never changes. Except when it does. Dragovic they're actually probably just a very famous family because I always see them. Oh, and Dragovic are the same as Krivia. So they might kind of inherit each other. My nephew has become my heir. He is a indulgent wastrel. I really don't want an indulgent wastrel to kind of inherit my lands. Please, just don't do that. We could go with some medium centralization or some high tribal organization. Let's do the high tribal organization one. It will probably pass. Of my vassals supported. My wife is pregnant, okay. Okay, thank you. I became diligent and when I was 56. Except I don't really need it. I have 5 daughters. You people would vote. Just normally vote for my child, my kid, my son, to become a king to inherit me. That would be awesome, but they're not even thinking about it. I'm not even looking at them. I can't see them from this far of the screen, but whatever. I'm just pressing the one that has money in it. And the Umyad is kind of failing, dude. Sorry to say. They are failing all the Reconquista. Jerusalem has been has defected. Oh, a son, yes! Split my country up even further. This guy is the king of Nayabid. Sultanate of Jerusalem. Probably a family, just a sec. Okay, I just paused the game, I'm sorry. Let's continue. My son became the skilled tactician. And he is marrying a princess of a sort. Or maybe not a princess of a sort. Let's marry this girl, she's attractive. Anywho, I might cut this video a little bit shorter because I must leave right now, but let's just continue. Maybe 6 more minutes or something. 5. And when it reaches the 21 mark, I'll just leave it. Empire of Carpathia! I could become an emperor! Yay! Now, I will lose the kingdom's insight, but I won't lose the Let's vote for my son, the gluttonous and kind guy. I won't lose the lands. At least they will be my vassals. Again with this guy. What the hell do you like about that guy? Jesus Christ. And now we're pretty strong. We are very strong, actually. We're an emperor. Which is hilarious. Nothing will leave my lands. Nothing will leave my grip. But we will have just two kingdoms inside us. Two kings that are pretty much as strong as we are. But we need to stabilize. Anywho. There is Gavelkind, elected Gavelkind in these lands. And I might Bohemia being my most important kingdom is actually leaving me. So that's pretty bad. We're setting for an expedition. 6. We're gaining 22 ducats. Anyway, the province that is not leaving me is Pomerania. And Bulgaria is leaving me too, so that's pretty bad. This was for my son. Just do that, please. For this son. Can I kill you or something? I can't. Let's just see. This woman, let's give her a gift. Nope, doesn't even. She's not even thinking about it. Let's give him a good gift. Okay. Learning skill helped us. Okay, loses the trade treaty. What a weird. Oh, I became good friends with the Emperor of the Abbasid Empire. Whoa, dude, that's quite a strong. I can just say a strong empire. I could attack them right now, and I wouldn't give a shit. But I don't really have anything strong to declare war on. Anyhow, this guy though likes us because we're friends now. Two emperors. And I'm still waiting for that claim. Is it coming any year soon? And stuff is just worrisome right now. It's a clusterfuck right now. Okay, but I don't care since there's a Slavic Empire now, let alone kingdoms. There's an empire. Just keeping every Christian from getting the more holier Slavic lands. There are more holes in these Slavic lands. There's this guy that is Serbian Orthodox that should be just killed right away. You know what the king is doing. And this guy's inheritance is worrisome. His heir is the king of Poland. So if he leaves, he'll just go straight back to Poland. But whatever. I can't do anything about it since I don't have any crown authority. There is no crown authority in a tribe. I'm a tribal emperor, I'm like Genghis Khan or something. But whatever. Come on, just get that claim. Selected claim, okay, just get it already. I will die and my land will split up. But at least even if the generation goes like that, the next one at least will have kind of more stable government. And this guy now is my heir. I will lose this kingdom, I will lose that kingdom, I will lose this chiefdom, I will lose this. Chiefdom 2 and that one. So you are going to be my new land, so I'm just going to invest in those lands. Who is voting for this guy? Who the hell is voting for this guy? Hi chiefs, can we kill you? Can't. Not really actually. Anywho, so guys, I will just finish the video right here. So if you did like the video, please like, subscribe, and comment. And I'll see you guys later. Bye.